Shingles, also known as herpes zoster, is a reactivation of the virus that causes chickenpox. After an individual gets chickenpox, the virus essentially goes to sleep. It becomes dormant in the body. And for some people, that's pretty much the end of the story. It just stays dormant for the rest of their life. However, in other patients, the virus can essentially wake up. And when it does that, it produces a very painful rash on the body. And that's what we refer to as shingles or herpes zoster. So if you imagine you kind of draw a line down your body in the middle with left and right halves, the rash typically presents only on one side of the body, and it can be very painful. The rash is most commonly located on the torso, like the chest and back area, but can also be present on the limbs as well as the face. One of the more concerning areas it can present is on or around the eye. And when that happens, we typically need an eye doctor to be involved in the care of the patient. It's very important to note that the pain of shingles can sometimes precede the appearance of a rash for days or even weeks. This typically occurs in patients who have a weakened immune system, which occurs naturally as people age, but also can occur if patients are taking certain immune suppressing medications, or another way of saying that is medications that impair the function of your immune system. So we generally say patients who are over the age of 50 and older, as well as those on medications such as high doses of steroids or methotrexate, azathioprine, mycophenolate, etc., there are many, are at increased risk for developing this. The treatment for shingles includes antiviral therapy that's targeted directly at the herpes virus that causes the infection. It's important that this treatment is administered as soon as possible, ideally within 72 hours from the onset of symptoms. The importance of rapid treatment is to prevent complications. And one complication that many people worry about is something called postherpetic neuralgia. What this is basically persistent pain at the site where the rash is. And this pain, unfortunately, can last months, even years, long after the rash is resolved. So that's the main complication that early treatment is hoping to prevent. Shingles is even more relevant for patients who have an underlying rheumatic disease. As I mentioned before, medications often used to treat these patients impair the function of the immune system, which is one of the main risk factors for developing shingles. So patients who are on many medications, including high doses of steroids, methotrexate, azathioprine, mycophenolate, the list is quite long. Those are all medications that increase the risk of developing it. So there is a vaccine that can help prevent the occurrence of shingles. The vaccine is approved for those over the age of 50 and recommended for those over the age of 60. However, there are patients under the age of 50 that are at risk of developing shingles, as we mentioned before, patients on certain types of medications. So it may be appropriate for them to receive this vaccine. So patients who have underlying rheumatic disease and are being treated with medications are allowed to receive the vaccine, but only in certain situations. In general, patients need to be on very low doses of medications that impact the immune system to be able to receive the vaccine safely. And this is a very individualized decision, depends on the patient's underlying disease, what specific medications they are on. So they should absolutely be speaking to their rheumatologist about whether it's appropriate for them to consider this vaccine. So there's a lot of exciting work being done in this field. There are currently ongoing studies looking at whether patients can safely receive the Zoster's vaccine while receiving higher doses of immune medications. In addition, there are different types of Zoster vaccines being produced that might provide safer alternatives to patients receiving medications. Overall, we'd like patients to be aware of what shingles is, how it can present, and the importance of early treatment. Particularly for patients who have an underlying rheumatic disease and are being treated with medications, we want them to remember that it is safe to receive the vaccine, but only under the guidance of their rheumatologist.